Okay, this review is so negative that my own system doesn't actually want me to post it, for this is about the fourth time that I'm recording it, but never mind. I gotta say that this is the first time I encounter a game that I can wholeheartedly recommend not purchasing in the current state. It is an early access title, so things may improve and my review might change, but let me break down as to why. For the first time ever, there will be no positives. I gotta say that I got this key for free from the developer, and this is probably not what they're expecting, which is why I will gladly revisit the game at 1.0 release to see if it changed and improved. So then, long list of negatives. There were zero players online on any of the matches. This game is multiplayer only sort of experience. You can practice your moves against bots and single player. I kinda expected it considering that it was an indie title, but do remember that this isn't like you have a story campaign to go through. No, this is all that you're paying money for. You're paying money to play against other players, and there's simply no other players to play against. Main menu alone maxed out my GPU. Practice maps maxed out my GPU and CPU. The game asked, can it bypass Windows Firewall upon launching? Yes, my computer is not an amazing piece of software, piece of hardware even, but it should never lag that bad, especially not on menus, and especially not in a game like this. I can't be sure if the game is just badly made, or if it's something worse, like a Bitcoin miner. If it is a Bitcoin miner, it would be the most incompetent miner in the world, for it costs £23 to buy, remember that. So I am gonna give this in the developer's favor and just say that it's probably incompetently made. There's no tutorial. I tried practice matches offline and couldn't figure out what I'm supposed to do. Considering that I could just respawn on the spot and the game kept on telling me that I was too close to the enemy spawn even when I was like half a map away, I could only really swing my sword. There was no explanation on what am I supposed to be doing. Enemies could shoot me from the whole map away if they felt like it, if they were ranged. And I just had no idea how to improve the score. Because you have the score at the top and I have no idea how you got it. Because clearly killing the enemies wasn't it. And there was practically nothing else on the map to do. So color me confused. Information on heroes only gives me their stats. There's an actual button on heroes that says more info. And if I press it, doesn't tell me their abilities, not what they can do, not their backstory, just their stats. Stats alone tell me absolutely nothing, and maybe you didn't want to write a backstory for your game. Considering that this is £23, I would have expected you to write a backstory for your game, but maybe you didn't want to. Maybe you didn't want to tell us why vampires are fighting in broad daylight while being healed by magic fairy people. Maybe you didn't want to tell us that. That is okay. The fact that I can't figure out what they do or which buttons to use to do that with, not okay. Your more info button, practically useless right now. In practice mode menu, the game didn't even register me attempting to change the hero. Clicking on heroes just didn't do anything. This online-only game that doesn't have any players whatsoever is pricing itself at £23. So to sum up my experience, I lagged, my system maxed out, the game asked to bypass Windows Firewall, there was no tutorial, there were no players online, simple menus like the Hero Select menu just didn't work, and practice mode just confused me. As of right now, I can't find any pluses in this game. I will gladly revisit it and change my review if there's changes to be made when it releases, but as of right now, I can't recommend to anyone to buy this